Everybody, every barber reaching for 100 grand. That's all they talking about because some other barber said it. 100 grand, 100 grand. That's why I shook down my old channel, maybe because I'm tired of talking about 100 grand. Right? I wanted to elevate. I wanted to get rid of all those people that were stuck on 100 grand. I wanted to get rid of all the haters and the naysayers. Right? I wanted to just start fresh, brand new all over again because I was stuck in that mindset. That's why I started fresh. I was stuck in a limiting poverty mindset. Yes, 100 grand is poverty. That ain't shit. Try go buying a nice house for your kids that you could raise your kids in for 100 grand. Make earning 100 grand a year. You ain't doing that shit, man. You fucked up, man. How much bills? Listen, 100 grand ain't nothing. Ain't nothing. It's something that's better than 30 grand, but you're scraping, man. You're still not, you ain't able to enjoy life, especially if you got to be there every day, all day, grinding and banging to do it. No. Aim higher than that. Aim bigger than that. That's why I said, look, man, I'm going to blast past your potential. The fuck you, what you thinking about 100 grand for? That's what they all say. 100 grand, 100 grand, 100 grand, I want to make 100 grand. That's just an arbitrary number that somebody just flipped up in the air because it sound good. Right? And it keeps you stuck. It keeps you stagnant. It doesn't help you think big. You ain't thinking big with 100 grand. If you just earning 100 grand, you cannot open 2 or 3 barbershops. You cannot open 10 barbershops with 100 grand. Try opening up a 10 barbershops with 100 grand a year coming in. Try opening up 20 barbershops with 100 grand. No. No. Stop thinking small. Okay? It's treasonous to be broke. It's treasonous to my fucking industry, man. So stop doing it. Right? You ain't helping another barber. You're not helping your clients. Listen, man. If you're out there trying to be broke, you pride yourself on being broke. You're not helping your clients. You can't serve your clients. You can't add extra value to your pitch. Why would they want to come see you to your barbershop? Man, all you do is cut hair. Why would they want to come see you? Right? What extras are you giving them? What more can you add on to the fire? You ain't doing nothing, man, if you ain't out there banging and seeing how much money you could get every single day. Every day you should be earning more money. Sometimes it doesn't happen. Sometimes it doesn't happen, right? Sometimes something happens. It gets weird, right? But you got to follow that up the next day with more action, right? You got to take a lot of actions, man, to build, grow, and bang. Make sure you're planting them seeds, man. If you don't got a whole bunch of little seeds planted and people are not rushing and looking for you and thinking about you all the time, listen, you got to be top of the client's mind. You got to be on top of their minds. Because if they not, if you are not on top of their minds when it's time to get a haircut, what they going to do? They're going to get a haircut or they're going to pay their phone bill. Because the barbers around the corner, that's not the only competition. All right, it's not just the barbers up the street. It's not them dudes around the corner or across the street. However your situation is that's not the only competition. You in competition with Newports. You in competition with the Weed Man. You in competition with Friday Night. You understand? You're in competition with the gas and the light bill. It's not just another haircut and another barber around the corner. No, that's average think. Right? You got to think bigger, right? Look, most people are broke. And if you're going after broke clients, that's what I told you yesterday. That's why you got to hop on these calls every day, man. Listen, one of the biggest mistakes that barbers make, right, is that they compete with the wrong competition. They competing with barbers who ain't worth spit. Fuck you competing with them for? Maybe what you want to get their clients, right? You want to compete with broke barbers to get broke clients? No. Right? Because what they're going to do, they're going to refer other broke individuals to you who can't afford to pay your services, right? They can't. So, if they only got $500 in their pocket, they had to get gas, they got to get their kids shit, right? Pay daycare, pay phone bill, right? Now, they only got $100 left, right? They got to get their weed, man, because you know people stuck on smoking weed, right? Getting high, they got to do that, right? So, what's next, right? They spent $40 on that, they got $60 left. What they going to do? Right? They got to go out to eat. They only got $60 left. Your haircut costs $30, $25. They can't afford you to cut their hair. They going to hold on tight to that last $60. They don't want to spend that last $60. So what are they gonna do? They don't know what to do. Should I get a haircut? Should I get a haircut or should I cut my hair myself? I can save this $30 and then I can go out to the bar tonight. Boom. Ew, I can get gas. Okay. Yeah, fuck the haircut. You know what I mean? I'm going to go do this. Right? That's who you're competing with. You're competing with decisions on what to do with that last $60. Right? And if you don't have a compelling offer, if your barbershop ain't rocking, give me 1 second. If your barbershop ain't rocking like how it's supposed to rock, right? And if you don't give people a vicious, vicious, compelling reason, right? I'm on the phone with you now. Hold on. Give me 1 second. You have a message. Right? If you ain't giving them a vicious, compelling reason to come see you, that they have to see you. If they don't come see you, whoo, your whole weekend is fucked up, right? If they don't, it gotta be that way. Come see me for a haircut or your life will be ruined, right? It has to be that way, man. Why not? It is, ain't it? What if they don't get a haircut? What if your clients don't get a haircut this weekend, right? What if they don't come see you to get a haircut? They're gonna get a haircut somewhere, but what if they don't come see you? Right? They're not going to have that magic. They're not going to be able to get the girl Friday night. St. Patty's Day. You know what I mean? They got to get naked. They ain't going to be able to get that job that they're looking for. You understand? They're going to look stupid on their wedding pictures if they don't come see you. Right? So stop playing with this shit, man. This game is serious. And if they don't come see you, what's going to happen to your daughter on her birthday? And she can't get that fucking power wheel that she want. But you can't get that American Girl down. And you got to make up some excuses like, baby, you don't need that. Nah, man, you don't need all that. You got to say some shit like that, man. It ain't the price of the dial, baby. It's the amount of income you got coming in. And you can't put it out because you chose to be broke. Fuck being broke and fuck being average. Stop playing with this game, man. And go out there and kill it. Go out there and bang. Go out there and get all of it that you can in this economy right now, man. We can get it. Don't turn on your industry, man. It was built. Look, we didn't even have to build this industry. It was already created for us. All we had to do was just step in and play our part. You understand? We ain't got to change the game. It's already good. People are already out there looking for sharp barbers. They're looking for barbers that's ready. They're looking for barbers that want their money. They want to give you money. They want to pay for it. Right? Listen, I don't charge my clients. Me personally, I don't charge them. I ask them how much you want to give me. And they be like, Raj, whatever, man. Put whatever. They give me the card and they just say, do whatever with it. Come in here and you'll see. Sit with me. Right? I'm like, cut their hair because of the service that I give them, the attention that I give them. Right? Ain't necessarily about the haircut. You probably cut way better hair than me. But I promise you, you cannot serve a client better than me. I promise you, nobody on this fucking planet out of 7 billion people cannot serve a client better than Raj the Barber can. They can't. How can... No. Right? Can't. I know what they want. I'm in tune with how people feel. I'm in tune with what they want. Shop is clean. I make people better. When they walk out of my shop, they become a better man. They grow. They get better at school. They get better at having sex. They get better at money. They become a better dad, a son. Everybody elevates after stepping up my barbershop. You understand? What are they coming to you, right? What's my competition offer? Just a sharp haircut? No, I make their life better. You understand? That's the proposition I got. Now, you ain't got to go that deep for your game. You can do something else. Be unique, right? Be you. But what I do is I make everybody in my exception to my presence, I make them get better. Why? Because that's what I wanted. And I didn't want my old life. I used to destroy lives. Right? I used to destroy people's lives, right? And I don't want that shit no more. And I got to work extra hard to hope I can fix that. Right? Because my grandkids is coming. Like, my grandkids is going to be here soon, man. I'm thinking about grandkids. You understand? Yeah, my son is only 11, my daughter 9, but time flies. You understand? Listen. My name is Vaj the Barber. I can go on all day with you, right? But I know you got to get to your grind. Listen, I hope you took good notes. And I hope I said something to you that'll make you snap out of it and stop trying to be broke, man. Get fucking rich. Make a decision to get filthy fucking rich. Get money. Become a millionaire in this industry. Why not? You can do it. Yo, my name is Vaz the Barber. Get that fucking money, man. Beats your